Good afternoon, UDA. I'm Ashley Hobbs.
And I'm Ed Smilson. We're reporting for TNN Trojan News Network.
Today's word of the day is aghast, which means terrified or amazed. That will be a good word to use with Halloween coming up soon.
Detention this week will be held in Mr. Fight's room, room 205.
Any students wanting to submit an entry for the 2015 VFW essay contest should stop by the guidance office for more details. Cash prizes range from $150 to $400. The theme for this year's essay is My Vision for America.
Any student helping with the Special Olympics next week should pick up a permission slip from the guidance office.
There will be a college fair on Wednesday, October 7th, tomorrow, during periods 6, 7, and 8 in the gym. 55 college and technical school representatives will be there. All students are welcome to attend. Please check with your 6th, 7th, and 8th period teachers to see if any of them will take the entire class. If none of your teachers are taking your class, you may still attend the fair one period by asking your teacher first for permission to attend and then signing up in the guidance office.
Are you going to the college fair?
I believe so.
The PSAT will be offered on Wednesday, October 28th. All college-bound juniors are encouraged to take this exam. Sophomores may take the exam now or wait till the later test date in January. This year's exam will have the new format and is designed to match the new SAT that is coming out in March. This is a great way to become familiar with the SATs before taking them. Cost of this exam is $16. Please see your counselor for more information and to sign up.
Reminder, there will be no club period tomorrow because of the college fair. We will run club period on Thursday.
Now let's check in with Carolyn Kerwin to see how the 2015 Football Educator Night went.
On Friday, September 11th, our Trojan football team hosted their annual Educator Appreciation Night. On this special night, senior players had the opportunity to highlight a teacher or aide they felt positively impacted their education. Various teachers were selected from different departments. I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Senior Coy Rickert chose Mr. Ayers as his honored teacher. Mr. Ayers is a popular biology and anatomy teacher for all grade levels. So blue and clouds so white, the
bright blessed day, the dark sacred night. I picked Mr. Ayers just because he's not only taught me everything from anatomy to biology, but like to prepare me for my career as what I want to go in to be a physical therapy.
That sounds really strange.
Me and Mr. Ayers, we used to lift in the morning, get ready for football season.
Mr. Ayers has been teaching at UDA for 20 years. He continues to leave a lasting legacy on our student body. And I think to myself,
what a wonderful world. The UDA and Lime Mountain Student Councils are working together to help raise awareness for breast cancer. They are selling Pink Out Game t-shirts for $10. These shirts will be worn at the Lime Mountain and UDA football game Friday, October 16th. If interested, please sign up in the office. Orders are due by tomorrow.
It's Tech Tuesday. Some of you may have updated to iOS 9 recently and may be enjoying its features, but there is a feature called Wi-Fi Assist that uses data if your Wi-Fi network is slow. If you have a data plan that is not unlimited, you should go into settings, click on cellular, scroll to the bottom, scroll to the bottom and switch Wi-Fi Assist off.
Did you do that?
Yeah.
Good. Now let's go over to Shanty Lowe with an update from the Trojan Sports Network.
I'm Shanty Lowe, and I'm here with your Trojan Sports update. Last evening, the Lady Trojans hosted the Wildcats from Halifax in their annual cancer awareness game, Spike It for Sight. The Wildcats won the match 15-8 after the Wildcats won the first two sets, 25-20 and 25-23. The Trojans battled back and won the next two sets, 25-22 and 25-23, to force the fifth set. The Trojans jumped out a 7-3 lead and forced the Wildcats' timeout. UDA missed the next serve wide right, and that allowed Kendall Lehman to score seven straight points for 11-7 lead. The Trojans were finally able to get a side out, but what little spark they had left vanished after another missed serve as the Wildcats would go on to win the set 15-8. The Trojans have now lost three in a row to fall to 8 wins and 6 losses overall. They will travel to Williams Valley tonight and try to get the 9th win. The girls' soccer team battled the Lady Dogs of Tri-Valley last evening as they played their member hero Beth Hirsch game. Tri-Valley would defeat UDA 3-1. Isabel scored an unassisted goal for UDA to avoid the shutout. The Lady Trojans' record now stands at 3 wins, 10 losses, and 1 tie. They return to action tomorrow as they travel to Juniata and take on the Indians. Now back to Ed and Ashley.
The following changes have been made for the UDA boys soccer schedule this week. The game from Saturday, October 3rd at Susquehanna will now be played on Thursday, October 8th, with varsity starting at 4 p.m. The bus will depart at 2:15 p.m. and students will be dismissed at 2 p.m. The game from Thursday, October 8th at West Shore Christian will now be played on Wednesday, October 7th, with JV starting at 3:30. The bus will depart at 1:30 and dismissal will be at 1:15.
For lunch on Wednesday, we will be having chicken rings with rice, steamed corn, chilled pears, and fat-free milk.
Thanks for tuning in today. Have a great evening, and don't forget, go big or go home.